I haven't made a YouTube video in over a half year. So feeling a little rusty, I typed into ChatGPT asking for it to come up with some video ideas, and this is what it came up with. So in today's video, I'm gonna be giving you a Semrush Masterclass deep dive into keyword research. We're gonna take an example website, show you exactly what I would do if I were trying to figure out what that site is all about, as well as coming up with some keyword ideas to help us in navigating in a particular space. You can apply these same principles when it comes to your own website in thinking about all the different ways that you might come up with some long tail phrases to go after. So without further ado, let's go ahead and get into today's video. All right, so Semrush has told me that in order to fulfill the intent of this sort of masterclass, I need to have covered some things around long tail keyword research and analyzing competitor keyword strategies. I'm gonna go ahead and ignore the local SEO keyword research side of things just because most of the time I don't work with local SEO. I focus more on the global scale of keyword research. So the first thing we're gonna do is we're gonna take a look at our website for today, which is we're gonna do a deep dive into the site outsourceschool.com. Just for background context, these are two guys that have gone through the years hiring different virtual assistants, and now they teach an online course where you can get access to all the different templates and resources that they used throughout the years to hire their virtual assistants. I haven't personally purchased their course at all, but I noticed that they were going after a space where I've created some YouTube videos in the past teaching all the different ways that you can leverage virtual assistants for your own business. And so I figured that I could use this site as a starting ground in terms of doing some keyword research. So background context is that we are working on ranking for some of the phrases around virtual assistants, which is all the rage sometimes these days, because I've noticed different influencers such as Nick Huber and others who have created these virtual assistant companies and sourcing companies to help different business owners with getting virtual assistants. One of the best things you can do when you are going through the organic research section of Semrush is just taking a look at what the trend says at the top of the page. So you can see here that this domain ranks for 638 keywords and has a traffic score of 34 or so in terms of estimated traffic. This is honestly not all that much traffic, so not super impressive. And you can also see how this chart over the years has been pretty unsteady or insignificant. So it looks like they did make a push in February or March of 2022 and they were doing pretty well with this site, but since then they've really struggled to get some placements. So right off the bat, it's always useful to take a look at this top section here, because by looking at this top section, you can just get a general sense of the directional sense of the site. What I also like to do here is I like to actually isolate for the different time periods. So looking at the last 6 months, I can see that they've seen a little bit of a jump, but very marginal at best. And in the last year, you can see how it's kind of hovered flat, if not a little bit of growth most recently. And then again, in that 2 year chart, you can really see how the story of this site is. It hasn't really done all that well in terms of organic placements. The next thing you can do is you can take a look at all of your organic search positions. I love going through this section because it really is the meat and potatoes of Semrush and its organic research tools. This is something in which one of the best things you can always do is just take a look by descending traffic influence to see what sort of long tail phrases are your competitors getting meaningful traffic from. So if we were looking at this particular case of OutSchool, a few immediate things catch my eye. The first thing is that virtual assistant for bloggers is giving a ton of traffic. It's actually 1 in 4 of the estimated influence of the organic search results. Also website development agency, as well as best virtual assistant. So when I'm thinking about these sorts of phrases and working through them, what I want to consider is I want to consider what are the long tail phrases that I care about with respect to my website. And from there, what I'm able to do is I'm able to start focusing in on the sorts of phrases that would be high traffic potential and high conversion potential as well. A great piece of advice I can give you is that generally speaking, when it comes to long tail keyword research, you want to focus on phrases that don't just only have traffic, but also have a lot of potential for conversion. This could be conversion in the form of requesting a demo of your service or product, signing up for a free trial, or even just something as simple as reading more content on your site. But what I can see here is that there's a couple of different phrases that these folks are doing pretty well on around virtual assistants. And what I would do as I go through this list is I would just kind of prune through this and start to notice some trends. So as you start to highlight some of these keyword phrases, one of the best pieces of advice I can give you is to always filter by positions. So when I go to positions, I like to go by top 3 or by top 10. The reason why is because these are the ones where they're actually going to likely be getting organic traffic from it. Anything after page 1, people don't really care about. So in this case, what you can see is these are cases where these folks are getting top 10 placements for these organic long tail phrases. So the next thing that I usually do is I usually look by volume. I can see that all these volume phrases are pretty low. low, 40, 70, 70, 50, 20. These are really not all that impressive. But one of the things that I'll think about when I think about the SEO strategy of this website is I will go ahead and see if I can stack a couple of these into a single master content piece or landing page in order to try to rank for a couple of these phrases at once. Because if you have the case where you have a few long tail keyword phrases that are, you know, 50 to 100 in volume, and you start stacking those where you have maybe 3 to 5 of those phrases getting ranked for, well, then you start to get hundreds of volume in terms of the monthly estimate, which then can become much more meaningful for your business. But the other thing I like to do, which I've gone over in my past videos, is I also like to talk about keyword difficulty. So notice how this is a great sign for me, in which all the keyword difficulties here are pretty low. They're generally under 30 or 40, and that's generally the sweet spot that I like to operate in because it doesn't require as much domain authority, which means that you don't need as many backlinks in order to start ranking for this content. So what I'll typically do is I'll typically filter. If I can, I try to filter by at least 100 or more in volume. However, in this particular example, I can't really do all that much here. And so I'm probably gonna just say, you know, minimum of 50 or more and apply that. And then go ahead and with my keyword difficulty, keep it under 40. So when I do that, I can start to see how I filter down these sorts of results. And now I see best virtual assistant websites as a top result, e-commerce outsourcing services, virtual assistants for entrepreneurs, YouTube automation outsourcing, Shopify virtual assistant, and so on. So as you start to work your way through your potential competitor's website, what I want you to think about is what are they trying to do with these sorts of content pieces? One of the best ways that you can research this is simply by looking at some of these URLs and seeing what they might be doing on these pages that are getting some general placements. So as you can see here, what they're trying to go for is a best of piece where they're going over the best virtual assistant sites for entrepreneurs. This is where they just kind of go through a rundown. And then in this example, you can see that they have e-commerce outsourcing services. So very similar idea. Pretty much what we're doing is we're creating a listicle sort of piece. And so the main things that I can take away from this is, you know, they're pretty much doing a standard content marketing playbook. I would actually argue that some of these sorts of posts are not all that meaningful because it's pretty generic right now as I go through some of these posts. But what is pretty cool is that they are testing out some of these guide posts where they're talking about the ultimate guide to outsourcing for YouTubers and things like that. So this is a little bit more interesting to me, but at a high level, what I can tell is they kind of have, you know, run-of-the-mill content. A lot of this stuff is not really that specific, and as a result, it's not ranking that well because it's lacking the authority that it really needs and the expertise in order to rank really well. So to summarize, I would say that OutSchool is working on some long-tail content. Where they could probably improve is with even more expertise worked into their pieces, as well as potentially differentiation of their posts. So these posts read kind of generic right now, so I'm not surprised why a lot of these positions are actually outside of the top 5 spots, which generally won't result in all that much traffic. As I start to summarize this though, this starts to give me an idea of what exactly might be working well for this site, as well as what could be going better. So in this case, the fact that they are ranking in the first page for these respective keyword phrases that I've shown are pretty interesting to me, shows me that it probably is not all that hard to rank for these phrases, and it affirms what I'm thinking about in terms of keyword difficulty here. So what are the takeaways for you as you're watching this video? Well, the first thing is always look at what are the sorts of things that people are already doing well with, because that can give you a starting point in terms of where to start your long tail keyword research. The second thing is when you see something where the content isn't all that great, but it's still ranking on page one, it means that that's an opportunity for you to one up that respective competitor and then take over their respective spot, if not go even higher. And number three, what I would say is you can often kind of tell what's working in a space based off of the content that is going pretty well for your respective competitors. And so in this case, you can see the listicles still seem to be working decently well for them. And also just in general, long tail content is working decently well too. All right, so once you've gone through some of the initial searches here, again, to summarize, look by position, look by volume, as well as keyword difficulty. What you can then also do is you can filter by intent. So oftentimes I like to filter for informational content first before going into commercial or transactional content, mainly because because informational content is traditionally, historically, a lot easier to rank for. And then over time, what you can also do is you can go by SERP features. What I like to look at here is the featured snippet, because oftentimes the featured snippet signals something that can be at the top of Google, which is really great because it'll get you that top placement, which will then feature your website and get more clicks. The other things that I like to do is advanced filters. Advanced filters, I've gone over it in a couple old videos of mine, but what you can do is you can go in here, you can actually filter by things like the URL, the traffic percentage, cost, etc. But what I specifically love here is word count. And I like to look for cases where long tail keyword phrases are greater than 3. And then filter through for that as well. So that'll give me just in general a good working list. I'll work that into an Excel sheet and then compare it to a couple other competitors as well. That leads me to the next thing that you're gonna wanna do, which is you're gonna wanna look at the domain overview and look at some competitors. In order to do that, what you can do is you can go ahead and go back into the overview of the domain. And then from here in this bottom right corner, you'll see a competitive positioning map. So this is where you can see all the other sites that are potentially doing very similar work to the site that you're interested in. So I can see that there's one on Outsource Doer and the Doer's Way. So let's go ahead and take a look at this respective site and see what they're all about. All right, so they're all about getting things done in your business, virtual assistants, business owners, so on. And so this makes complete sense. And so here, let's go ahead and take a look at what they're doing here. So view details. And what I can see here is this site is doing a little bit better than Outsource School. So they've got 216 keywords, 2.1K monthly traffic estimate. That's great. And what you can see is that they're actually driving a lot of their own traffic, which is interesting. But you'll also see that, you know, there's a lot of, you know, branded traffic. This is not as interesting to me. What is interesting to me, though, are the lower phrases where it's like outsource task to virtual assistants, outsource administrative assistant. These are all new ideas that I would start to think about as I respectively think about the long tail phrases in this area. The next thing that I'll do is I'll usually go into the keyword magic tool. So once you go to keyword magic tool, you'll go into something like this. I've gone ahead and searched virtual assistant. And here what you can see is you're gonna see a lot of different search results here. What I like to do is run through that same criteria once more. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna go ahead and look for at least 100 or more in volume, keyword difficulty, keep it under 40. I'll apply all the things that I went over earlier. Intent, I'm gonna go for informational. And I'm also gonna do word count at least 3 or more. And now I'm gonna see that there's a ton of different phrases here. So Pinterest virtual assistant, virtual executive assistants, virtual executive assistant, social media virtual assistant. Notice how all these phrases are actually higher volume and potentially have a lot more, you know, traffic behind them. And so what I'll typically do from here is I'll typically look at the results and I'll try to get a gauge of all the different ways that, you know, what this data is telling me. So another cool thing you can do with the keyword magic tool is go ahead and do an export. And from here, when you export this into an XLS file, it'll download that file. And then you can go ahead and open that file up. And from Excel, you can copy and paste that into ChatGPT in order to have it read through this for other information that might be valuable to you. So let me go ahead and show you what that might look like by going into ChatGPT. I've gone ahead and pasted this in. I'm using this prompt. Now act like a Excel and SEO specialist. So please summarize some key findings with relationship to long-tail SEO research that I've exported from Semrush. Please expand upon your response in the format of a table, considering factors such as keyword difficulty, number of results, and competitive density. Please also include a factor where you, on a scale of 1 to 5, you assess the difficulty to rank that phrase. And then the last thing I'll say is lastly, please brainstorm 10 content ideas for a blog targeting these long tail phrases. Here's the data set. All right, so I just went ahead and pasted that data set, and now I'm gonna have it feed through. And now it's organizing the data, summarizing the findings, and here we go. So Pinterest virtual assistant, difficulty to rank 2, volume 1900, keyword difficulty 13, competitive density 0.99. So here's the content idea, top 10 tasks a Pinterest virtual assistant can handle for your business. Virtual assistant, executive assistants. So here you can see, you know, it's a difficulty to rank 4, 1300. Look at the reason why it's saying that. It's saying that because the CPC is a little bit higher here. Competitive density is higher as well. Notice how the number of results is also a lot higher. But what's really nice about this is now you're able to take the long tail keyword research that you came up with and apply that into a content piece that you can then create a content brief for. So this is going to be a great way for you to just streamline some of the work when it comes to analyzing different opportunities and having some sort of an assistant to help you out along the way. Well, from here, what you can do is you can actually continue to go down the rabbit hole with the keyword magic tool, It's an awesome way for you to learn more about the different keyword phrases that you might be able to rank for, and also just build upon the work that you've already started from today's video. Hopefully you got value out of today's tutorial. In the case where you want to check out Semrush for yourself and haven't already, feel free to use my trial link in the video description below. And also from here, if you have any questions, feel free to leave them in the chat and I'd be happy to answer them. All right, see ya.